I'm so into you. Anyways, okay. Right, three.
It's not like that.
And then we're all out of turn. Fam.
I'm so. No, it's like.
You are, you, you are something special.
I take you on a shopping spree.
Cause I'm so into you. Okay, anyways. Back to the video.
That was the loudest clap of leaving, fam.
Well, it's Adam, Zeebo here. Three E's, no caps, two eyes, no gaps. And today, I've brought back Course of Conflicts. Now, I know, yeah, the last episode was like 10 months ago, but I was just like.
Imagine 10 months.
Yeah, I didn't. I was feeling a bit iffy about the whole.
Was that the
Kitchen
legal
Kings
one?
And Course of Conflicts, yeah. But I've changed my mind now and I'm back on it, yeah. Kitchen Kings will be more of them. Course of Conflicts, there'll be more of them.
Basically, Zan flopped when he was on his f***ing gap year. Yeah. You literally flopped your entire life. Like, you literally had like big aspirations, like big plans to do nothing. So you literally did nothing.
But I'm joined with the one and only Chamzino.
What go on, what's goodie, subscribe or tip?
That was so never good.
Yeah.
And obviously, your boy Champs here. I actually don't even get it. Explain.
Wagwan, what's goodie, subscribe or tip? As in Udi, like. Wagwan, what's goodie, subscribe or tech. Yeah, subscribe or tech.
No.
And we have got Hamza Khan, yeah, it's been long awaited. I'm pretty sure this whole series started because of the argument we had, all three of us.
Yeah, literally.
And Hamza's and we were now. Like,
oh, thank you, Hamza, we'll take your argument, we'll never include you in the video.
How did it even start? It started off with bullying, isn't it?
If you haven't seen the previous Course of Conflict,
Damola was in that video, isn't it?
Yeah.
Damsey in the stress.
No, that was about spitting on the dog. The bullying one was Luca.
Oh yeah,
bullying one, part one and part two was Luca, like.
So, if you haven't seen the previous Course of Conflicts, we spoke about bullying being a mentality. This guy was saying how bullying doesn't exist. You can watch the video in it, you can come to a conclusion.
Nah, I justified myself though, don't really? Lie.
Anyways, and the other episode was, we were talking about that Brooke House
spitting on the dog.
Yeah. This YouTuber spat on her dog basically and uploaded the footage by
accident. Yeah, we were just violating it.
And Neil was laughing at her basically.
No, so. Yes. No, I'm a good guy.
No.
Alright, so I'm bringing Course of Conflicts back, and in today's episode, firstly, there's just so much shit that's gone down in 2020. There's so much to talk about.
Yeah, man, in the past 10 months, isn't it?
Yeah, I think the first one we're going to talk about is 6ix9ine, because this guy is just a very controversial guy, and I feel like we've got differing opinions. That's one thing I wanted for this video, yeah. It's something that we've got to kind of have to have a different opinion on. If we agree on it, then it's not that entertaining, innit? Because, like, you know, I want it to be
entertaining.
That's
the whole purpose of the video,
I personally think... You can't snitch, bro. You can't.
Oh, are you just going to jump straight into it?
Let's just jump straight into it.
Okay, say that then.
You can't snitch, bro.
First thing, yeah, you state your opinion, then you say yours. Okay. And then we'll go on.
6ix9ine, one of the most, famous people at the moment in the music industry, yeah. He snitched in jail. For those of you that don't know, his whole team basically snaked him, and then he was in jail, so he snaked them back, and he was let out of jail. He was let out of jail early, basically. And a lot of people calling him a snitch. Yeah.
No, but you know that type of snaking is different. So, like, obviously his brethren try to, like, kill him and stuff. Like, that's one, like, level of snaking, innit? But snaking it to the feds is a different story. Like, in New York, fam, like, in America, yeah.
There it's is a G-ting, like, bro.
It's a G-ting.
Put it down, bro.
Yeah, carry on.
But it's a G thing over there. Actually, it's like a G code. Like, bro, some man, yeah, on a G, like, on an actual, on a G thing.
Okay, we're listening.
On a G thing, some man actually don't even know some killers to famous rappers. Like, I don't even know. No one knows who, like, killed Tupac or Biggie or some shit like that.
But there's bare conspiracies about that.
Bare conspiracies, but no one's going to snitch because that's like, bro, if you snitch, you're going to be known to snitch, yeah? Like, let me tell you something about 6ix9ine as well. He is young, yeah? And, like, he snitched to get out of jail. I get that. And he knows if he went in jail, he was most likely going to die in jail. But when you come out and you're known for a snitch, I don't wish it upon him, but he's most likely going to die out of jail as well. Like, brothers, bro, like, Pop Smoke did nothing wrong. Someone went into his yard and shot him. But anyone can die.
That's a different situation.
No, but anyone can die is what I mean.
Let's get to the most important question, yeah?
Go on.
If you were 6ix9ine,
yeah,
and you were in his position,
yeah,
and your whole team snaked you and, like, took money from your concert, like, the money that you would have made from concerts and stuff, they basically finessed half the money and stuff. They snaked him or whatever.
Slept with his baby mama as well.
Yeah.
Would you snitch?
I can't snitch to the feds, no, bro.
Okay,
so I'm sorry.
The CIA, don't know.
Okay, wait. So if you were in his position, and someone literally said to you, okay, cool, you're going to get a reduced sentence if you just state the things that we are trying to look for, which he did, like, he just snaked whatever they were looking for.
50 years to 2 years, for example.
Okay, question,
he was on, like, 60 years, I swear, and they dropped it to, like, 2 years.
Question, yeah. Now, 6ix9ine, understand, yeah, the streets are more like, it's more difficult to get around, fam. Like, them man there are so invested in whatever. Like, 6ix9ine was obviously invested in all this gang business, yeah?
Yeah.
With Bloods and Cardi B and all them man there, yeah? But, like, yeah, my brother, yeah, like, if you're invested in it and you have problems in the streets, bro, everyone knows that it's the code. You can't tell feds, bro. Like, you're also baiting out other people. Like, he baited out people that weren't even involved, like Trippie
Red.
But
he got snaked first.
No, but he got snaked by his brethren on the streets, but then you snaked it to fucking corporate, fam. You basically snaked it to the federal police. Like, oh, you snaked me, you found my baby mama, so I'm going to go tell Lieutenant Jonathan
for 25
Smith.
Years.
Four longer.
If
longer.
The streets...
Four people that snaked you out.
If the streets has said that, and that's what's happened to you on the streets, then you have to...
Actually, you know what? I agree with you, you know.
You can't...
It's a G thing.
Okay.
Bro, you take it seriously, man. No, but on a G-ting.
I'm
getting
excited for a second.
No, but on a G-ting.
Oh, yeah, carry okay,
on. On a G-ting.
Yeah, yeah. We'll listen.
No, but on a G-ting, bro, you can't... You just can't snake it. Like, you can't do it, bro. Everyone knows the streets.
So,
like, you can't
so 25
do it. Because you are going to be known for a snitch. I'm not going to bait any names out in it, but I know someone that snitched on someone, and he went to jail for a bit. But the only reason why he went to jail is because he snitched on him, and now this brother, he's waiting that he's gonna die. He's
okay,
gonna
but look at okay, look at 6ix9ine's situation as well. Yeah, so he's got I'll a kid. He's got a kid at home. Time. He's got a kid at home. Yeah. So deep it, you're gonna abandon your daughter or whatever.
Yeah.
And your whole family and everything. He's got parents as well, of course.
Just
yeah.
for a couple guys on the streets.
Just for.
But then now. Do you understand what that means when you snitch? You now have a death.
Forget
like,
about
you are
that.
You are on a bounty, bro.
You're on a bounty either ways. You're either in jail living no life, or you're outside.
Yeah.
Surviving a little bit, it's peak, but you've got a better life.
Okay, and your daughter's gonna grow up and know, oh my god, daddy's a snitch. Like,
she's not gonna think that. She's gonna think my dad. I'm lucky enough to be with my dad in the first place.
Let me stop you right there. Before you watch any further, make sure you like this video so I can see if you guys are enjoying the series. And make sure to comment your opinions, because one of my favorite things about filming these types of videos is reading the comments. So make sure you comment who you agree with, or if you have your own opinion, I'll read all the comments. Anyways, back to the video.
Bro, the streets are so volatile.
Wait, Paul, so if for 6ix9ine's daughter, yeah? She's got two options, yeah? Either she could have her dad be in jail her whole life and be like, oh, why did dad have to be involved in this gang stuff?
Yeah.
And, you know, not, why did he just snitch? Or she'd be living, like, with her dad and because he snitched, and she'd be able to live her life with her dad.
Bro, it's so tight.
She
could get got for being a thingy snitch, bro. Yeah, for being a daughter.
She's not gonna see that. She'd rather have her dad with her.
Bro,
everyone would.
Bear in mind, now you are risking the life of your people, you know that. Now that you snitched, yeah, you're an accessory to it now. Like, you're all a part of it. Like, now you snitched to go see your daughter could get got. Like, your auntie could get got, your mum could get got. Like, my brother, do you know how volatile it is, fam? Like, bro, people don't care, fam. They'll literally shoot you for no reason, fam. Like,
but the thing is,
volatile, fam. The streets are mad, especially over there where you're actually allowed to have guns, fam. You can basically walk around with a skeng, fam. Like, no one's gonna, bruv. It's New York, fam. It's Zoo York, fam. Like,
New York.
Like, it's more volatile than London. We will never know because we don't live in the US, innit? But when you hear stories and stuff, and you understand the gun laws and stuff,
not New York either, innit?
No, but how do you know their culture's like that then?
Bro, think about London, yeah? We're not even allowed guns and yet there's still shootings. Imagine if we're allowed guns. It's going to be similar to New York, bro. Like, shooting left, right, centre, aunties getting popped. Bro, I'm seeing aunties, bro, mothers getting stabbed. If you lot live in London, you'll see, bro, mothers getting stabbed, daughters getting stabbed. Someone in Streatham was 5 years of age. She got shanked, bro.
Yeah, I saw that.
Five. What did she do? What has she done? What could she possibly do?
Okay. Stay on the
Do you get me?
It's
Pete.
With 6ix9ine, yeah, regardless whether he's in jail or he's not in jail, yeah, people, even before this whole snitching thing happened, people were onto him regardless, yeah? Yes or no?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
People just didn't like how he was at the top, how he was winning, yeah? People still were envious of him, yeah?
Mm.
Anyway, so if he snitched, yeah, he can either now live outside of the prison, yeah? So he can still be, people will be still hating on him and everything, but he's not in jail. Or you can be in jail, where you're being watched 24/7. You're limited on everything, yeah. You're only allowed out when they say you can go out, yeah. And people in the jailhouse are still going to be trying to kill you. What would you rather, the freedom out of the jailhouse or in the jailhouse? Do you hear me? Because regardless whether you snitch or not,
knowing
the situation,
let's be real. If you go out, you're just giving yourself a false reality. Knowing the situation, yeah, I'll come out. I'm free. Like, no one's gonna want to kill me. Bro, you're most likely
But he's got bodyguards and that now.
Every single day of his life.
Or live outside, but with bodyguards.
People are on you regardless.
But bear in mind, now you are known for being a snitch too.
But when you got the money and stuff, and okay, you have to do what you have to do to survive. Do you care?
Bro, it doesn't matter. Bro, money or not, it doesn't matter.
Listen, I'm not saying whether he's a snitch or not, because I wasn't in a situation to be able to even speak. How do you know? There's people that are going around saying, oh, six hands a snitch, this, that, yeah. But they haven't even lived that situation to even say. If they were in his position, I bet you, yeah, the people that are going around saying snitch, snitch, snitch. So I bet half of them will probably snitch themselves. 100%, yeah. Bro. Yeah, if you have a if you had a family, yeah, that you have to look after, you got your mum to look after as well, yeah, whether she's old or whatever. Fam, all you have to do is say, state. People that snitched on him already, it's not even him going out of his way to snitch. People that have snitched on him already, yeah?
Yeah.
You're just doing what they just did to you. They stabbed you in the back, yeah? You're not stabbing them back in the back because they've already done it to you. Do you get me? It's like...
But it's techie because it's 6ix9ine. Okay. If it was me, I'm not 6ix9ine, I'm not that famous.
Bro, that's my point. Are you saying it because it's just 6ix9ine or are you saying it because you mean it?
Bro, it's just 6ix9ine. He's so famous, fam.
So you don't like how he's famous?
No, bro. You can't do that if you're that famous, bro. You could get... Bro, a civilian would even try to kill you for no reason.
But do you not see where I'm coming from? Do you not see where I'm coming from?
I get where you're coming from, yeah.
You're only saying it because the guy is famous. You're not saying it because of whether it's right or wrong.
But it's still kind of wrong,
you're saying
bro.
It because it's 6ix9ine. If Jay-Z was in this situation, for example, or Kanye West, yeah, big names in the game,
yeah,
and they did exactly the same thing, snitch on someone that basically snitched on them.
Yeah.
I promise
you. But did they snake on 6ix9ine? Did they go to feds and say 6ix9ine did this and did
no,
that?
No. I'm just saying, let's just say they were 6ix9ine and they snitched on people that snitched on them, yeah? Which is what happened to 6ix9ine, yeah? Half of America and the world will not be saying, oh, 6ix9ine's a snitch, or in this case, Jay-Z's a snitch.
No, but you know there's a difference, right? From getting snaked by your brethren and trying to get M'd on the streets, then snitching to the feds, snitching to go to jail. They are two different things. You can snake me, but then if you snake me, I'm going to go feds and snitch on you snaking me. Do you get what I mean?
Which is what he did.
But that, bro, they are two different scenarios. If, for example, them brethren went to jail and they said, or went to like court or whatever, and they said, yeah, but I know who killed blah blah, it was 6ix9ine, I know who did this, 6ix9ine. Then they snitch on you already, so you're already in the deep end. So if you have the opportunity to snitch, yeah, you're going to jail anyway, so you may as well snitch because they already snitched on you already.
You just said one through one.
Do you hear what I mean?
Because it was just a snake, it was just a normal, it was just a street snake thing. It wasn't like a police snake where they went behind your back to the feds and blamed a murder or an M on you or something. Mm-hmm. Do you get what I mean? Are you even listening?
No, I'm not listening. No, you said something before, yeah, and I've been thinking about it for the last 2 minutes. Yeah. That's why.
Say something. Do you agree with me, yes or no?
No.
You guys definitely
went on a different tangent.
Yeah.
The most important question I wanted to ask, is if you were him, and you had a choice, you were already in jail, and you had a choice, staying there for 25 years,
or take two years
and snitch on all these ops anyways, and get out. And you got the world.
Now bear in mind, you are literally
the most popping artist. Yeah, you got all the money waiting for you, all the house, all the cars. Obviously, there's a massive risk of getting shot, or whatever. But, well, you don't live in jail, fam. You're probably gonna get shot in jail anyways, or killed in jail anyway. So go to jail and die, or live your life for a bit at least, and then maybe die.
So then why would you even be on the road then?
Look at this guy. Do you think he's a serious candidate? Look at his face.
Yeah, I've seen his face, fam. You know what? Get the picture where he's a female. You know in that video.
Whether you're at that level, like a rapper's level, whether you're a pro or a good guy,
your career is way more important than the.
That's one thing.
But people, does he take his career seriously?
People are going to be on you regardless. Yeah, look, what did Pop Smoke actually physically do wrong for him to get popped?
No one knows. I think it's just because it's a G thing. That's why.
He abated his address, or someone abated his address and someone pulled up to his crib, and shut him up.
Okay. Straight.
People are going to envy you regardless whether you're a snitch, bruv, people tried to shoot 50 Cent. Obviously, that was a street thing.
He got shot
as well.
8 times.
That was a street thing as well, but.
Nine.
But he, what did he actually do wrong? Right, he was on job and that.
It's just because he's a gangster, bro. That's it. It's just because he's a part of the affiliate. He's an affiliate, fam. But that's the thing, though.
People are onto you regardless.
That's cool.
I bet there's people that are onto people like J.I., fam, that are just innocent people. Just because they're big, yeah, You know what? Let me just do anything to try and knock this guy down.
Yeah, 100%. 100%.
So regardless, when you get to that level, I think it's a thing where it's like you got to protect your career and your family. But that's your number one priority.
But
put your pride aside, for the time being, and just think to yourself, what's more important to me? My career? Think about the long term. Don't just think about the short term. The long term was
45 years. It's way more risky.
The long term was 45 years for him. With the short term, 22 years. Let me just do what I need to do. Now, let's think long term. Now I just need to deal with the situation when I come out of jail. I need to think about what I'm going to have to do and say now about everyone trying to be onto you and try and defend your own name.
Which do you reckon he went about it the right way? Man's embracing the fact that he's a snitch.
That's not for me to say because there's very controversial things that he does which I don't agree with.
I don't know. I just think it's difficult to understand like how the streets have changed now. Like before, that would never run. Like,
but the thing is, things change. When did screaming and shouting in music ever be a thing?
When would it never run?
But never, bro. Like back in the day, Tupac's time, fam. Like that will never run.
But
like,
that's changed, fam. Look, different. Just look at
that. That can never run,
fam.
Do you think
things gonna be the same? Look at him. Look at him. Do you think things gonna be the same?
When did you see people like Lil Pump, Pop Smoke, Trippie Red, like with that type of hairstyle, tattoos?
But I wouldn't think they're like invested in the streets though, which is mad stupid. I think they believe that they can be invested in the streets because they rap about it. And then you know when you rap about it or you think about it so much, you convince yourself you're part of it.
I can literally say
I'm in a gang, and I can say it for 2 years straight, and then I'll be like, oh shit, I'm actually in a gang, you know? It doesn't make sense, but you believe it. And it's like, come on, man, look at 6ix9ine, like, is he really on it? Like, look at him.
But then you just contradicted yourself. Look at his face, bro. But you're contradicting yourself.
That's the thing.
Bro.
Is he really on it? No, because he's snitched.
So is it deep then if he's not on it?
Bro, he was still. No, because now, of course it is, because now he's not actually on it. He hasn't got brethren to back him. He's got bodyguards who might just leave him one night, and he's risking his family's life every single day. I would personally, if I had the family, and I'm invested in the streets, which God forbid, I hope I never do, I would never have, bro, why would you have a family, have a daughter when you know you can die any minute of your life? Do you hear me? Why would you even bring that on your daughter? You would want to raise it for the time being.
But he had a daughter and that before this all happened.
Yeah, but he didn't just choose one day, let me be in a gang. He was born in it, fam. He was born and raised in New York. Like,
you just said he's not part of the gang, though,
bro. No, but it doesn't look like he is.
6ix9ine?
Yeah.
This guy wasn't born in a gang, fam. Have you seen what he used to look like at prom and stuff, fam? This guy was not born into a gang lifestyle.
Half of this is just a picture.
Yeah, but
it's all a picture. It's not just 6ix9ine.
But the current situation, what he's in now, he's clearly invested in some gang business. He's clearly invested in some gang activity. And everyone knows you can't get out, bro. It's so hard to get out.
Before we start talking too much about the whole snitching situation, there's more stuff to talk about anyways.
Just leave it like this now. But say, like, everyone leave your opinions now in the comments.
I just think, for the respect of my family, I wouldn't want to snitch, bro. Because, like, you're risking your life every single day in New York, fam. Like, unless he moves to wherever he's from, Mexico, whatever, then you might even be safe there. But even there, bro, I don't even know. I swear to God. I wouldn't risk it. Like, come on, man. You have
enough.
A daughter.
Fair enough. I say for the last part of the video, probably only, like, 5 minutes left, but there's a couple of things we can talk about 6ix9ine. But the main two things about him being a snitch and, you know, about him being hated and stuff for whatever reasons. Basically, one of the main reasons, him saying the N-word, like, I don't know, like, bear people, always what's it called, get onto him. A lot of people don't care for some reason. I don't know why. But basically, he's Hispanic, and he's going around saying
But Hispanic people, like, them type of people do say it, though, because, like, Jay's Puerto Rican, but, like, he says it. But I guess, like, you know where Central America is, They call it, like, Caribbeans, but do you know how close it is? Like, Puerto Rico,
Peru, but
and, like, they're so close.
It's more of a culture, it's like, if anyone that's not white, if you get me, like, I guess they say it. Like, there's the blacks,
because
the Hispanics.
See, that's the thing, it's also, like, me as well, like, it's mad confusing, because...
But you're actually from Africa,
if I was to say
but it doesn't look like it.
You look like a Sri Lankan, innit? But you are actually African.
I look like one banging, like, but in Mauritius, bro, like, you don't understand how it goes down. Like, we are... Like, bro, half of the country is basically half and half me. Like, I'm brown, and then it fades from brown to, like, black, and then you have
countries like Morocco as well.
They say that word a lot. They say the N word a lot, but it's normal to them. Do you get me? So I can say it in the country, but I can't say it in this country because people would kind of look at it differently in this country, and that's fine, isn't it?
What I was gonna say, a lot of people was a quote saying cancel 6ix9ine for saying the N word, whatever, but then they'll continue to listen. to other rappers who aren't
exactly,
black.
Yeah, exactly. This is what I was going to say.
J.I. says it.
No. Shall I tell you what
I'm a corporate of this as well, innit? Like, for example, that, bruv, saying the N-word is like, it's still bad, innit? But like, you got rappers who are murderers and stuff, like, yeah, YW Rebellion stuff. And if some people be like, oh, I don't listen to 6ix9ine because he said the N-word, whatever. But then more time you're out here listening to drill rappers, murderers and stuff. So where's the line? Like, at the end of the day, the way I see it, the whole music industry is so tapped.
It's
like,
corrupt right
it's now. It's so tapped. Yeah. Like, everyone's a murderer or a rapist or like whatever, do you know what I mean? They're all just tapped in the head. So David Rami, it's bad. That's another topic we can talk about. But no, it's tapped, but yeah, like, yeah. I mean, they're all tapped, so you have to just
firm it. There's another thing, yeah. A lot of people that, not the artists on this thing, yeah, it's more the fans. I say a lot of the fans are hypocrites as well.
100%.
Because, shall I tell you something, yeah, and that's including us guys as well. I'm not disincluding us lot, because we can be hypocrites within ourselves as well. But the thing is, yeah, you get people that are like, yeah, like, for example, everyone would get onto 6ix9ine for saying the N-word, for example. Yeah. But there's many other rappers. For example, someone like J.I., yeah, who's a Puerto Rican. He says the N-word as well, yeah? But because 6ix9ine's at his level where he is, yeah, at the top, people will get onto him more.
Yeah.
Because they would do anything for his downfall.
That's just, to be fair, yeah?
Yeah?
That's just how society is, though. Like, whoever's the most famous, they're going to come up with everyone's TL. So when you see, like, let's say just a random, like, I don't know, a middle-aged white person doesn't know anything about rap yet. If you just see 6ix9ine come up on the TL, and you see him saying the N-word, obviously you're gonna say, "Why is that saying?" She might not even know who J.I. is. Do you know what I mean?
Of course, but of course, you didn't realize.
100%.
People love to hate, like, but you know, the more famous you'll get, yeah.
But there is a difference.
You'll get way more people that will hate you for no reason.
Like, you could wear something you. And they'll like,
they'll just hate you because of you. Because of you doing your thing.
Remember, there's a difference between hating and actually, rightfully so, getting onto someone for, you know, saying the N-word when they're not
so,
black,
so
do you know what I mean?
Overall, it's the same thing. Would you say 6ix9ine saying the N-word, would you say he's classed to be able to say it or not?
Two things.
I think they're classed. To be fair, it depends where
you're from. None of us are black to say this in the first place. But
two things. I'd say I'm not from the area where he's from to see if bare people say it when they're not black, whatever.
Yeah.
And second thing, like, at the end of the day, yeah, if you're not black, whatever, or you don't go through slavery, whatever, then
it's not for us to decide.
You shouldn't really say it,
anything.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
But that being said, there's certain rappers who say the N-word who are murderers and stuff, so, like, they're all tapped. Like, they're all just tapped.
Another reason why the fans can be hypocrites as well is because, for example, there's people that, like, let's say they're like 6ix9ine, yeah?
Yeah.
They'll be like, oh, 6ix9ine says the N-word, I'm not gonna listen to him. Yeah, because he's not black and he raps about, saying the N-word. But why would you listen to artists, like, even if they are black, yeah, that say the N-word as well? Because if you firstly don't want to hear that word in music anyway.
Yeah, so what?
Why are you saying it just because 6ix9ine saying it? But when someone is black, I know they're allowed to say it.
What I'm just saying, yeah, because that's another thing.
That's about the whole
use of, like, the N-word and stuff. Obviously, we're not black. You might be African, but then, at the end of the day, you're bloody flanking it. And what? Like,
I'm still African.
You're just Caucasian, innit?
That's why. So, like, in my country, see that? Now, that's the thing. Like, again, like, I'm saying from my point of view, yeah, I wouldn't do what 6ix9ine did because he's saying it in the US, innit? But if he was doing his thing in, like, Mexico, or if J.I. did his thing in Puerto Rico and then he's saying it, more people would kind of understand it because in the country they speak it. Like, I could say, like, in Mauritius, they say the N-word freely purely because, like, it's a slave country, innit? So, like, we're kind of looked in the small light because we're a small country anyway. Mm. So, all these other bigger countries, like Central America, one, you know, the Caribbean, basically. Puerto Rico is so close to Jamaica, fam. Like, it's literally in the same area, fam. So, them and they are basically the same, fam. Like, if they want to say it, yeah, like, fucking say it, innit? But if you're white and you say it, then, yeah, I don't know what you're doing, fam.
I think, for white people, it should be wrong.
I was gonna say something, like,
because obviously, that just makes sense within itself, innit?
Because slavery came from a race war anyway. So,
yeah.
Like,
oh, yeah, that's what I'm gonna say.
If you were white and you're saying a word that you know your own people called slaves, then my brother, like, it doesn't make sense.
No,
like,
and the thing is, a lot of black people would be pissed off more if a white person say it rather than an Asian person or Hispanic.
Yeah,
or
that's the thing I was gonna say from before, yeah, is about you know just how rappers say the N-word anyways. Yeah,
yeah.
Obviously,
yeah,
we're all like Asian, whatever. We can't really be talking too tough, or our opinion don't really care anyways. But
no,
it matters, but like
everyone's opinions matter. But it's like, you know, people just need to realize certain situations.
Anyways, so you see how, like, bear rappers use the N-word and stuff. Yeah, so they, like, they don't want other people to say it. Yeah, but then they continue to rap about it. Yeah, so for example, there's that video of Kendrick Lamar. Yeah, and he was at a concert. He was performing at a concert, and then he invited a fan up, and then when the fan came up, yeah,
a white fan,
I think the song, we must have said the N-word like,
it said the N-word like bad,
and then he said it, and then Kendrick Lamar made it all awkward, as like, whoa, 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 should we kick him off stage? And they were like, boo, boo, boo.
It was a girl, was a, or something
like
that,
yeah. And I'm just thinking like, okay, fair enough, yeah, you should have maybe like not said it. Like, it's not that hard to not say it, but I mean, you're saying it, you're one of the biggest artists of the, you know, of rap.
It's influential.
Not just Kendrick Lamar, like, all rappers, yeah. Like, if you want everyone to be rapping to your songs, you know people are going to be rapping at home and stuff. Like, you're saying the N-word, basically saying, look, if you want to rap my lyrics,
it generalizes
say the N-word.
They make it like it's a common word in society, basically. Exactly.
Because they've got to realize that it's not just black people that listen to their music, do you know what I mean? And if they say it so commonly and stuff, I get, you know, they say it all the time, whatever, but I don't know, just all I'm saying is, if they say it all the time, and then they get a bit, you know, surprised when everyone, the word becomes a bit more normalized, because they're already singing it at home all the time and saying the N-word, because it's just in their music.
Yeah, just because it's not on camera, that doesn't mean it's not being said.
24/7, and it's just become, like, the rap industry normalizes the word, the N-word, and they can't act surprised or upset when they can to an extent, but they can't be like, you know what, they can't get, oh, why are you saying the N-word in my lyrics? Like, my brother, you literally asked him to, come on stage.
I do get what you mean.
Obviously, it's a difficult situation, though,
like, because... Even if you do make music, because music means more to like some other people, innit? Like, some people just make music just to get peace. Some people make music just because it's a wave. But some people genuinely express their emotions. So if they want to say the N word, and they're black or they're Hispanic or wherever they're from,
yeah, there's levels to it, obviously.
Then you can say it, and obviously you can genuinely feel offended if someone else says it, because let's be real, yeah, the whole rap industry is still growing. Like, bro, like, it's not really meant to appeal to those type of people that can't say it anyway. Do you get me? Like, the whole rap industry, it's out there. And it could be mainstream, but it's not really made for those people that are... Because it links so back to that racism.
I feel like it's gone, rappers, it's so big now, it's literally the biggest music genre. It's gone
to the stage. No, it's not. It's like, if you do concerts and stuff...
You know rap genre is the biggest genre now?
Well, like hip-hop.
You know it is, you know that. Statistically, it used to be... I don't know.
It used to be pop.
It used to be rock or something like that, yeah, or country, whatever. But now, rap is the most listened to music industry.
Do you think?
It is. No, it's a statistic. It was like, I saw on Twitter a few months.
Maybe because rock is dying out now, isn't it? Yeah, like, all them rock bands and stuff.
Think about, like, when you see like Drake and Travis Scott getting billions of views, and 6ix9ine, they're not billions for no reason.
This is the biggest industry in the world.
So it's not even just like a black community thing anymore, fam. You got rappers like Lil Dicky and Eminem,
but they don't say the N word though, because I feel like the N word, and like, I feel like you can't mix the N word with music, fam. If artists do say it, yeah, then. Whatever, innit? Like, they can say it.
A counter argument, though, like what a black person may say is, because it came from black culture originally, hip hop, even I believe R&B came as well.
Probably.
Yeah. From black culture, they can turn around and say, listen, you people have came onto our wave. Do you get me? Like,
we were
rapping this word in our music for the longest now. Now you lot came into the game here. We should stop saying it. Yeah. I'm not saying that's what they say.
That's a good point.
But they could turn around and happily say that to us.
That's a good point. And whatever you guys think, you know, leave your comments. I love to see.
Of course, 100%. It's not just for us guys at the end of the day.
But yeah, definitely give your opinions of what you think about the whole 6ix9ine situation, about, you know, the N word and all these rappers using it, snitching, all of that. But I think that's a wrap up for
today. So anyways, that sounds quite good, you know. I can't even lie to you. Me and Hamza got heated, fam.
Yeah, I know. So anyways, make sure you smash the like button as well. Subscribe if you're not already.
Hope you don't like that one, you get me?
I'm gonna try to keep these calls to conflicts a bit more frequent now. Maybe monthly, maybe every 2 weeks. I don't know yet. I'm just trying to suggest topics to talk about a bit more frequently. Suggest more topics to talk about, and
What's the light target?
I say
300. I'm saying 300. What are you saying?
Whatever Hamza's saying. Yeah, just
300. Free bills.
If you like the video,
how many likes did you get last time?
Like 250, something like that.
Defo 300 then.
300 then? No, 50 is kind of hard to get. I can't lie.
It is hard. Okay, whatever.
275.
You can do it, fam. 300 likes.
Free bills then.
As long as you enjoy the video, just like it.
Free bills of likes.
If you don't enjoy the video, like it anyways, okay? See you guys next video in a bit.